Guiyang is the capital of Guizhou province in the south of China. Still only few tourists come here, also there is a lot to explore here. Along the Nanning River there are some landmarks from the time of the Ming dynasty, such as the Fuyu Bridge and the Jiaozhou Tower, built in the late 16th century. Many street markets offer all what people need here: animals, vegetables, fruits, and exotic spices. And the preparation of dinner will be celebrated as a special event. The Qianglian Shan Park is located in the northwest corner of the city. Like in all parks in China, people sing and dance here. The monkeys, however, wait to snatch something eatable. On the top of the mountain, the Hongfu Temple attracts many visitors and people to pray here. This temple was built in the early stage of the Qing Dynasty. By train, it takes about 4 hours to the ancient city of Zhenyuan. The marvelous old town stretches along the Wuyang River. Zhenyuan is a cozy little town where people can explore the variety of the local handicraft, among others the production of candies and rice wine. North of the city, stairs lead to the ruins of the southern Great Chinese Wall. By bicycle, it's easy to visit some of the nearby villages. In the evening, the river and buildings are illuminated with romantic light, and on both sides of the river, restaurants offer delicious food for dinner.
Thank you.
After a 1 hour drive by bus, I am at the most spectacular section of the Wuyang River. From the little boat, remarkable caves and waterfalls can be seen, as well as steep rocks mirroring in the crystal clear water. In this house, rice noodles are made by handwork. The new Peak Pagoda is now the town's landmark. By train and taxi, it's a short 3 hours drive to Xichang via Kaili. Xichang is a lovely village of the Miao minority who settled in Guizhou mountain areas. The big, closely spaced wooden houses extend on the steep hills on both sides of the valley. A walk along the fields, apart from the paths tourists usually take, offers a good impression about rice cultivation and also how houses are built here.
Thank you.
The traditional songs of the Miao sound very strange in the ears of Westerners, but this music is really authentically and not made for tourists. There is a small museum which is managed by a family who lives here since generations. The big rain only disturbs people for a short while. The rain does not even prevent this barber from doing his haircut.
Yeah.
The owner of this shop produces candies and rice wine, a nice place to taste both. Also, weaving women can often be seen in this region. Today, the Long Table Festival is celebrated. Along these tables, people eat together and enjoy the night with drinks and music. The firework closes the day and the festival. In the early morning, minibuses bring people to the town called Kaili. From here, the train takes about 2 hours back to Guiyang.
Thank you.